come to math class afterwards, and my teacher would have just a really silly joke on the board just to start off the day. So if you guys haven't heard of this one before, like, what does a duck use in math class? You know, the answer is everybody?
A
coagulator, that's right. but like Miss Williams said, my name is Miss Elizabeth, Miss O. And I just remember being at your guys' desk. Like, math class was always a big challenge for me. Who likes math? Like, everybody, that's awesome. That's awesome. No, but for me, again, math was a challenge, and it was very difficult, like, trying to get the right answers and really understand it. But when I went to my mom, she was just like, sweetheart, math is kind of like a puzzle. You have your word problems, or you have your, you know, your equations down, and you have a bunch of little puzzle pieces. You just gotta find that missing puzzle piece to get the whole picture. And for that reason, you know, I started to like math a lot more. I started to understand it, and I realized like all of our classes in school is kind of like a puzzle. With English, you have to find that missing vocab word. With math, you gotta find the answer. So with that, we're gonna start with lesson 11. And we're gonna do the odd numbers for lesson 11 first. So can someone read the first question for me? Okay, Andrew?
The school relay team has three extended runners.
Right, okay. So we have some pieces of the puzzle right now. We know that the total of the race was 3/4 of a mile long. We know that one person ran 1/12 of a mile. Does anybody have an idea of how to solve this problem? JP?
Maybe we have to see how many, also one person could fit into the 3/4 of a mile.
Okay, you're right. So we have 1/12 of a mile. So would it be like equal to 3/4? Is that what you're trying to say? Trying to figure out like how many 1/12 can fit into 3/4? Okay. So, do we know what to do after this? Andrew?
1/12 should be 3/4 into 12, should be 9/12, and then if each runner ran 1/12, then there's 9 runners.
You're right. But how did you get, you said 3/4 is equal to 9/12. How did you get that?
4 times 3 is 12.
Okay, so we did 4 times 3 is equal to 12. So we found the common denominator on the bottom. And then 3 times 3 is equal to 9. Because remember, whatever you do to the bottom, you gotta do to the top, right? And just like Andrew said, if one person ran 1/12 of a mile, that means that it would take 9 people to run 9/12, right? And 9/12 is the same as 3/4 of a mile. Right. So Andrew is right. The answer is 9 people. Does anybody have any questions on this? Do we all understand everything? Raise your hands if you understand. Yeah? Okay. Joey, do you have a question on the... No? Okay. Alright, so awesome. So we got number one down. Can someone read number three for me, please? Alright, Joseph?
8.64 subtracted by 1.4.
Okay. Does someone know how to set up this equation? Alright, Stephanie, do you want to write it on the board for me? Okay. So the answer is correct. The answer is 7.24. Okay. So I really like how Miss Stephanie, she remembered to align the decimals. She dropped it down. And in the question, it was just 8.64 minus 1.4. But she remembered to put in that invisible zero there. So So it's a lot easier to just subtract. Okay. Any questions on this one? No? All right. So number three, do I have a volunteer for number three? So the question is, find the volume of a rectangular prism. Actually, you know what, guys? If you want to grab the whiteboard mark or the whiteboards on the table, and if you want to like solve the problems with us, that's cool too.
Yeah, I don't know about you guys, but in math class, I love using the whiteboards.
In the meantime, does anybody have any questions? Do we all remember how to do the volume of a rectangular prism? Length times width times height.
Okay. Has everybody finished working through the problem? Does anybody still need a little bit more time? Raise your hand if you need like a few more seconds to answer the question. Yeah? So raise your whiteboards or raise your notebooks if you guys got the same answer as Miss Genevieve's. Did we all get 33.75? Yeah? Okay, awesome. So number seven. It's a super simple one if you remember your definitions. I know Ms. Wilson went over this one beforehand. All right. So number seven asks, what is the definition of an absolute value? Who remembers what an absolute value is? Kyle, what's the definition of an absolute value? Okay, so awesome. The distance between a number and a zero on a number line. Yeah. So what does that mean? If we have a number line, zero's right here, right? We have 3, we have -3. What would the absolute value of 3 be? Eva?
Yeah.
3. 3? Okay, why? Okay, cool. Okay, but what about the absolute value for -3? So it's 3 away from 0, you're right. So in other words, guys, whenever you have an absolute value, no matter what, it's always going to be a positive number. The answer is always going to be positive, okay? I remember whenever I had my math test and, like, our section was on absolute values, like, I got this, you know? -7? 7. It was just, like, the quickest, the fastest I've ever finished a math test before. So let's see. So number 9. Can someone read number 9 to me, please? Okay, Joseph?
The tree outside AJ's home was 3 feet tall when he was born. By the time AJ started school, the tree was 3 feet as tall. When AJ graduated from school, the tree was 3 times as tall as it when he was in school. How many feet tall was the tree by the time AJ graduated?
Okay. Another way how I figured out the pieces of the puzzle for my math problems is by drawing it out. I like to see what I'm working with. So we have, what was the main character's name?
AJ.
When AJ was a baby, the tree was how big?
3 feet tall.
Awesome. Now, when he became a kid, how much taller was the tree?
3 times taller.
So it was 3 times as big, right? And then when he graduated, how big was the tree then?
3 times
bigger than the tree, right? It was when he was a kid. So, okay, Eva?
Oh, I called it the man in the ocean.
Exactly. So when he puts this into an equation, we find out that it's 3 times 3 times 3, right? But we remember that when you have the same numbers being multiplied in a row, like 3, 3, and 3, to write it in a simplified version, it'll just be 3 to the third power. Does anybody know 3 to the third power equals to? Okay. 27.
Because we have 3 times 3 is 9. Times 3 equals 27. Okay. Any questions? Raise your hand if you understand this. Yeah? Okay.
To simplifying stuff like this, you always want to remember it in steps. So the pieces of the puzzle. So the first piece, remember, you just multiply 7 times 2. Wait, so I'm going to do this one. Okay. Can I show you something real quick? Alright. So we have 3 pieces to this puzzle. We have piece number 1, piece number 2, piece number 3. I'm going to take this one. That's right. So whenever we have to simplify stuff, we always gotta remember our little symbols, our addition signs and our subtraction signs. So let's give 2 claps for both Miss Reese and Miss Jenny for finishing off this problem. Ready? 1, 2. Okay. Okay. All right. JP has a good idea. 1, 2, 3.